there are days where you have to learn to keep your personal baggage aside, what is happening, and still try and find, because you can't put a subtitle, aaj mere pair mein dard tha because boots were tight, aaj mera lunch acha nahi tha to mera mood kharab tha, you know. कभी कभी मैं सोचता हूँ यार डिसाइड तो कर ले, तू फॉलो क्यों करता है मुझे अगर इतना पसंद नहीं करता वो, अगर मैं उनके बारे में कुछ बोल दू, यू नो आई ऑलवेज वंडर, आपके बिल्डिंग के नोटिस बोर्ड में मैं आपके बारे में कुछ लिख के चले जाऊँ तो आप किसी को शक्ल नहीं दिखा पाओगे, यू फील सो एम्बैरस्ड.
आई एम श्योर यू नो अर्जुन यू आर प्रमोटिंग द मूवी, बट डज इट फील डिफरेंट दिस टाइम प्रमोटिंग मूवीज ऑन Zoom कॉल्स एंड यू नो नॉट एक्चुअली मीटिंग पीपल इन रियल?
It's slightly simpler actually. Actors are able to keep time, so if I tell you 3 o'clock at best, 3:10 ho jata hai, not because of me, because of the digital problems. So actors are not getting blamed for time getting wasted. It's very odd, honestly. But the only upside to it is there's a certain discipline of time, and you're not really doing too much. You're doing just exactly what is necessary, keeping the circumstances and situation and the kind of film it is in mind also. You're not spreading yourself too thin as an actor by repeatedly doing the same thing, because 15-20 days are dedicated to marketing. You're consolidating to say 3 to 4-5 days at best. Mm. I think it's better. I think it saves a lot of time, money and energy. Mm. And it still gets the messaging across, because right now theaters are shut. Once theaters open, you'll be appealing to a different dynamic of audience that perhaps doesn't use social media and the digital technologies. Then we'll have to rejig the way we go about approaching that. Maybe television comes in then, and maybe going on ground activities might return. Meeting the local media through different platforms might coexist again. But as odd as it feels, I think it's the most safe and practical way of going about it.
You know, Arjun, as Indians, you know, we are always close to our grandparents, and we miss out on a lot of things, you know, like appreciation or just gratitude or just expressing of, you know, the expression of love. So what's Correct. One thing you would like to tell people, or something that today you feel, oh, I probably missed this, or I have not missed, good, I did not miss that?
But I think the last 1.5 years has anyways made us reconnect to a great degree with our emotions and our families. You know, a lot of people realize what you're saying. I always say this, you know, it's just about being grateful.
Yeah.
That you have a family that you can get upset with also. Hai na?
Hai na, that's true.
So just be happy ki hai. Because bahuton ke paas wo nahi hai jo aapke paas hai. Aapko hamesha wo dikhta hai jo dusron ke paas hai. Lekin कुछ लोग आपके घर में जाकर देखते और खुश होते हैं कि आपके पास वो सब है.
You know, as an artist, as someone who's been part of the industry for so long and a family, you know, you guys discuss numbers, you guys discuss everything. So how do you see OTT as a platform, A? And do you think that has changed dynamics for the industry for long now?
See, firstly, you have to always learn to adapt and accept the situation you're in. You have to evolve with time. So when films were being made also, different kind of films started coming in. So multiplexes came in. That time people said, yaar, multiplex culture, kisi ko samajh jayega, kaun 500 rupaye dega ticket dene ke, dekhne ke liye jaake AC. Aadat hai humko ek tarike se film dekhne ki. Wo evolution aaya. Tabhi us samay pandemic nahi tha, lekin there was an evolution in the education system, in the youth coming in, our country got younger. People got more and more influenced by Western civilization because technology came in, the digital medium started coming in, internet became available, 3G, 4G aana chalu hua. Today, we have to accept and adapt to the fact that we are in a pandemic where entertainment is still the need of the hour, but you cannot jeopardize somebody's health to entertain. So you have to allow people to be entertained at the comfort of them feeling happy watching a film, not being scared about koi cheek dega to main dar jaungi ya dar jaungi. Therefore, the evolution of OTT in India has been faster. Perhaps Netflix can answer it better, but I'm sure they were envisioning 10 years to seep into the country. Perhaps that is going to happen now in 5 years because of the fact that there has been a exponential growth in need for entertainment in the last 18 months. As an actor, I'm happy. I have another way of entertaining and reaching people. It's very important to accept that why should it be one versus the other? Why can't it both be together? Because one will help the other. OTT will help us find better actors, better technicians, better directors, better stories, and the correct stories for the correct platform. And therefore push theatrical films to be of a certain caliber, because agar aap us level ka kaam nahi karoge, to log ghar pe hi picture dekhenge. I love going to theater, the big screen, popcorn, discussing the film physically together. You know, people crave physical connect. Watching it with 100-200 people, the laugh makes you laugh, the fear makes you scared, the taali brings your taali, it resonates. Wo rongte khade hone wali baat hai theater mein, aur wo hamesha rahegi. देखिए फिल्म थिएटर में लगती फिर ओटीटी पे आती तो ऑडियंस तक पहुंच ही जाती है। अब इस वक्त थिएटर पे नहीं जा सकती तो ओटीटी पे आ रही है तो और बड़े ऑडियंस के पास पहुंच रही है। एंड देयर इज नो परसेप्शन क्रिएटेड बाय थिएट्रिकल नंबर्स, सो व्हाट हैपेंस, योर फिल्म हैज अ क्लीन स्लेट। इट इज अ डिफिकल्ट टाइम फॉर एंटरटेनमेंट, बट वी आर वेरी ब्लेस्ड दैट वी आर एबल टू पुट आवर फिल्म्स आउट देयर। सी ये फिल्म वरना वी वुड हैव हैड टू वेट a long time, because the big films would have come in and then something as heartwarming as this would have come in. That would have maybe made it stale. So I'm happy that OTT platforms exist and I'm happy that they've come and I'm happy that India has allowed it to happen. Because I feel the content now post 2024-25, aap dekho ke agle 3-4 saal mein na, you'll see an evolution of content also because of this time.
In last 9-10 years, I think all your movies had strong female characters.
Thank you for noticing it. I've noticed this time, a lot of people have noticed this part about my subconscious selection. I'd never planned it like this here, but I think that's just me growing up with the strong women in my life, where I don't see women as a threat. I've never had that ego tussle with women. I've never selected material purely selfishly ki mera role kaisa hai. I always look at sabka role acha hona chahiye. I always get excited because I guess my upbringing film wise also is Ishak Zade. You know, I did a film where Pariniti had a fantastic role. For the first time, I think I've seen a woman put a gun on a man's head and she's holding a gun in her introduction. It was really interesting to know that that is new India in that sense. At that point, that was the new part of India. Aaj wo thoda common lagta hai because aajkal katta bahut sari ladkiyan pakad leti hai, hum dekhte hain OTT shows wagera pe. It's not that new, but that time it was very new. There is no reason to be afraid of good female characters. Whether it is Two Stages, whether it is Finding Fanny, whether it is Key and Ka for that matter, the thought also is very strongly female oriented in that sense. I just love strong female characters. I feel it makes a film more attractive and well rounded.
I don't use the word failure. I mostly use the word as, you know, areas to improve. So I just want to know from you whether over the years your definition of success and areas to improve has changed.
To be honest, when Two Stages released, it's not like I was overtly enjoying the success. I was still looking at how I can do Tevar better. I was shooting that. So it's not like you get caught up in your success and don't think about how to improve even then. It's something as basic as you realize the fact that if you are good with your lines, na, it becomes so much more fun playing out scenes. There are certain scripts that you don't always learn everything. You know, you come on set and sometimes you learn. But now... In 9-10 years, you realize, okay, that's something that really helps me. The days where the dialogue is in my control, my craft is stronger. There are days where you have to learn to keep your personal baggage aside, what is happening, and still try and find, because you can't put a subtitle, aaj mere pair mein dard tha because boots were tight. Aaj mera lunch acha nahi tha to mera mood kharab tha, you know. You have to learn to look beyond the minor obstacles that come your way. Of course, failures teach you more than success does. And failure is not a bad thing. It means you took a risk, you tried. Agar aap fail hue, matlab aapne koshish ki.
Internet has become a boon in all our lives, but at the same time, it has its own negatives. So, you know, trolling is a common thing these days.
Yes.
I have seen you handling, it in a very cool manner most of the times.
See, I'm somebody who's done the roast, so I have this ability to laugh at myself. I don't take myself so seriously that I don't understand when a joke is being made. But at some point, a line gets crossed and things become personal, and people get some vindictive pleasure by overdoing it. That is unfortunate, and that comes a lot from the inbuilt frustration and certain amount of anger that is embedded into the people that have phones in their hands. You know, because of the circumstances and the way the world is, there is a lot more negative emotion and energy, and it feels like an outlet. And logo ko lagta hai ki yaar stars ko bol denge to thoda lighter feel hota hai. You know, apne doston ke saath baith ke bolte hai, dekh maine aaj ek joke raha ki ha ha. For them, it is a way of they're shedding some negativity away because unka haq hai, because they pay money to watch our films. They feel that they have that right to say whatever they want, whenever they want, without caring what we might feel. Because you don't do that to your sibling or your parents or apne doston ko aise nahi bolte. But humko bolte because it seems like we're available to them now at the behest of typing certain words. It might make them feel better, but I just wish they'd kind of realize that we are also human and it does take a toll on us mentally, emotionally, physically. You can feel drained reading it. When you talk about my work and there is criticism, you always try and learn from it, like you said, and respect it. When it gets personal, then you realize that people's heart is not in the right place. So that shows more about their upbringing than it does about me. आप जिस तरह अपने अपने भाई, अपने बाप, अपने माँ, अपनी अपने अपने रिश्तेदारों से बात करते हो, अगर मैं उनके बारे में कुछ बोल दू, यू नो आई ऑलवेज वंडर, आपके बिल्डिंग के नोटिस बोर्ड में मैं आपके बारे में कुछ लिख के चले जाऊं तो आप किसी को शक्ल नहीं दिखा पाओगे. यू विल फील सो एम्बैरस्ड. इमेजिन व्हाट यू पुट आवर फैमिलीज थ्रू व्हेन यू राइट रबिश फॉर द सेक ऑफ फन. एंड देयर आर पीपल हु राइट रियली नास्टी थिंग्स, स्पेशली अबाउट वुमेन. एंड आई हैव रेड दैट. आई एम तो स्टिल अ गाय. आई फेस्ड फ्लैग फॉर जस्ट माय फिजिकैलिटी एंड जस्ट फॉर बीइंग अलाइव एंड बीइंग समबडीज सन. मैं क्या करूं, अपने शक्ल बदल दूं, अपना नाम बदल दूं, क्या शुड आई फील सॉरी फॉर हु आई एम? We get taken for granted far more, and that's so sad and unfortunate. But I hope it improves. I mean, I give the benefit of the doubt to our audience because they give us a lot of love when films release there. So perhaps if the films were releasing in theaters and life was normal, you don't give it so much importance also, because the love you get when you travel, when you meet people, I do not believe that there is so much negativity and hatred out there. And most people that write all this about you are actually following you. So it's quite a paradox.
Yeah.
तो कभी-कभी मैं सोचता हूँ यार, decide तो कर ले, तू follow क्यों करता है मुझे अगर इतना पसंद नहीं करता वो. But then, hey, अब ये reality है आज के दुनिया की. Bigger stars than me get trolled. Cricketers who are superstars get trolled. They play well one day, then they don't. The next day they get trolled.
Thank you so much for this honest and lovely conversation. It was.
Thank you so much.